他这个四周给他包围起来了。嗯，啊，嗯，you'll
have to get Mark to explain that.
After she passed away.
When did she pass away?
About 5 years ago. I just realized that now I knew what she meant, that it's just, there's no life in here. There's just concrete. It's barren. She used to think that this was Dallas's, downfall, sorrow. She used to think that she never used to say that she's from Dallas. She goes, "Oh, you're from Texas. Just say you're." People would think that you're evil or something back in her day, but. I don't know.
People in the 60s really associated this area with nothing but Kennedy's assassination.
People just hate Dallas people.
Oh, really?
So I brought her a picture of my goddaughter and lit a candle for her and just hoping that she remembers that. We remember that she was here.
That, and she brought you here. It's amazing that you remember it when you were so young.
Well, I just remember the stories. I remember that she bugged for him. She was the first.
Do you think that's how people are going to be with? September 11th and our children when we talk to them.
I think in about 20 years, September 11th won't even be a memory. It just be something that happened and just be, you know, the only thing we can ever come close to is Challenger, because, you know.
I remember where I was.
Yeah, I was in third
Thank you.
Got us.
Dana points.
I guess closer to 12 it gets, the better. I mean, that's what everybody says. Really. be at your best at 12, though.
I think the best is inside of the stuff.
Yeah. But it seems like people don't want to come in there when we're in there, though. Because they're, like, walking and, like... Yeah. Because it's like, it looks like we got more people in there when we had the long shot, you know, at the street. Because they were walking in there and they didn't even notice. When we were in that corner, they, like, walking around us and trying not to go up to it.
There's no solution
for it. But then it's shaky.
Playing it like I was. Maybe. You won't be able to do a sustained shot.
Thank you.
like security personnel, like, okay.
Thank you. John 5, don't you?
The idea for this memorial came from
Thank you.
afraid of ISIS going down. Oh, it's part slam on it. What about this like really big nice?
Thank you.
rồi bà ngoại với mẹ vô đi. Đấy, rồi bà ngoại với mẹ đi, tôi chụp nhiều rồi bà ngoại với mẹ.
Baby! Ali!
see you.
Just put it in your pocket.
Where?
Everybody who's taking part, go behind the reef. Assemble behind the reef. Everybody, you guys can join in if you want. It's free. Come on, guys, join in. Come on. Come on, it's free. You guys can join in too if you want to. Come on. Where's Billy?
Here.
You can walk up here with us.
Okay. Yeah, this is my girlfriend.
Your name?
Yeah. This is my wife.
Hey, Billy.
Yeah.
Where's
Mr.
Williams?
Mr. Williams! I feel pretty good. Hey, drunkie! On your cue.
Thank you.
And survive beyond his mortal being and continue to draw us to his immortal soul. President John Fitzgerald Kennedy is now a legend for the ages, and just as his life provided us with comfort against the apocalyptic darkness, so too will the resolution of the mystery surrounding his death serve to let us listen to some of President Kennedy's words so that on the 40th anniversary of his death, we may use them both to grow into hope and to build a better life for their children. Not merely peace for Americans, but peace for all men and women. Not merely peace in our time, but peace for all time. So let us not be blind to our differences, but let us also direct attention to our common interests and to the means by which those differences can be resolved. And if we cannot end now our differences, at least we can help make the world safe for diversity. For in the final analysis, our most basic common link is that we all inhabit this small planet. We all breathe the same air. We all cherish our children's futures. And we're all mortal. We in this country, in this generation, are by destiny rather than choice, the watchmen on the walls of world freedom. We ask, therefore, that we may be worthy of our power and responsibility, that we may exercise our strength with wisdom and restraint. Is there an honest man or woman among us that can deny that those selected passages from President Kennedy's aforementioned speeches stand in stark between the Warren Commission apologists and the assassination research community? Let them come to the grassy knoll. There are some who say that lies are the way to the future. Let them come to the grassy knoll. And there are even a few who say that it is true and lies legal. But it permits us to protect our national security. Let them come to the grassy knoll. President Kennedy loved poetry, and so it is fitting that this memorial speech to his life and the battle for the market price this year.
Now, he is from Great Britain. Welcome, Ian Briggs.
President, but he was now leader. Oklahoma just to get in here.
Thank you.
We will overcome. We will. Because we have numbers, we have faith, and we have God. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd just like to take a moment and say, am I the only elected official that dared come here today? Is this it? Where's the governor of Texas? Anyway, though, I'm not the governor anymore, I'm a civilian now. But they do tell you you're always the governor, you're just not the current one. So there you go. But on a serious note, I came here today because this is the 40th anniversary. I was 12 years old when President Kennedy was shot and killed right here. A matter of about probably 15. Gives me the hope that when I come out here today and I see a gathering like this, that eventually we will prevail and the truth shall prevail because the truth will release us all. But I want to just say we have to keep this up. The vigilance must stay. We get no help from the government.
Yeah, I'm the only elected official who currently elected went and sat face to face with Fidel Castro. I asked Castro specifically in the last 20 minutes what he did. Told me at that moment Kennedy had sent a European reporter to meet with him. And Castro firmly believed that President Kennedy quite possibly was going to take a new position that had happened internally. And that was his position. And I did my homework and I found out that yes, indeed, it was true that that reporter was with Castro at the moment Kennedy was killed. I found out that Castro's quote at that point in time was, this is very, very bad. And Castro also told me they didn't do it because he said if I had, people wouldn't exist today. They would have been blown off the face of the earth. And I tend to agree with him. He's not a stupid man. He knows where his bread is buttoned. Anyway, again, I'm going to end. Thank you very much. It's terrific to be here in Dallas.
I cannot see with the viewfinder.
Thank you. black
crazy being like right in the middle. So I wasn't comfortable.